And we have breaking news. NBC News has confirmed a New York Times report that Hillary Clinton refused to fire her 2008 campaign faith advisor after allegations of sexual harassment on the job. Joining me now, Maya Harris, former senior policy advisor for Hillary Clinton's 2016 campaign, and MSNBC political and legal contributor, and Elise Jordan, MSNBC political analyst and Time magazine columnist. Thanks very much, Maya. This involves Bernd Strider, a former faith advisor in 2008. He was also working for Correct the Record, a super PAC for 2016 campaign. I don't know if you ever knew him and if you had any information at all about this issue, but that Mrs. Clinton, Secretary Clinton at the time, candidate Clinton in 2008, refused to fire him from the 2008 campaign after complaints about his behavior.
Well, you know, I actually, Andrea, was not on the 2008 campaign, so I do not know this individual, and I'm not familiar with the circumstance of the case other than what I, you know, read in the newspaper that just broke. But what I can say is that, you know, I think we should have a zero-tolerance approach to sexual harassment, sexual assault of any kind, and that's whether it is, you know, the first incident or the fifth incident, that there should be, you know, consequences and accountability every single time. And what that looks like, though, may be different in one case under one certain set of facts than it may be under another set of facts.
And we do have a statement from the law firm that was advising her campaign in 2008, which is that to ensure a safe working environment, the campaign had a process to address complaints of misconduct or harassment. When matters arose, they were reviewed in accordance with these policies and appropriate action was taken. This complaint was no exception. Well, that doesn't tell us what actually happened, whether there was any action taken, any punishment at all. In 2016, this individual was also involved in Correct the Record, which was a super PAC that worked for the campaign and apparently was then let go. I don't know if you had any knowledge of that at the time, but Elise Jordan, what does this say about the pressure on all political figures, especially women, but not just women, and certainly Hillary Clinton, who was at one point criticized in this current explosion of criticism with the Me Too movement, that she took a while before criticizing her very strong supporter and close political ally, Harvey Weinstein?
Well, there's zero tolerance in politics now for having individuals continue to work for you who have committed these acts, and there's zero tolerance for sexual harassment. And so while a politician may want to shy away from punishing a close aide, that's not the climate, as it should not be, because there should be repercussions for this kind of inappropriate behavior. And I think that this is an example, though, of why voters did not trust Hillary Clinton when it came to issues of sexual harassment and assault, just because of her husband's association in the 90s and what happened to his victims. And so that, you know, whether rightfully or wrongfully, she was lumped in with Bill Clinton's treatment and the perception of him as a predator.
But Maya, a lot of women and men felt that it was unfair to blame her for what her husband had done back in the 90s. And in fact, in this past campaign, there was, of course, the Access Hollywood tape and the fact that she was running against a man whose record was arguably very checkered, to say the least, on the subject of sexual harassment or sexual relations.
Well, yeah, I think that, you know, we are, you know, quick to not allow women to be able to run on their own record and to, you know, introduce other elements, including potentially things that may have involved their spouses. I think that at the end of the day, you know, Hillary got out there and ran on an agenda that she thought was going to be good for America and on the issues that she actually thought would make a real difference in people's lives. And unfortunately, we are where we are. With a president in the White House who is every day now undermining and delegitimizing our independent institutions of government and, you know, leading us down a path that I hope for our country and for the sake of our country will not be irreparable.
And I should point out that Bernd Strider was eventually fired from the super PAC Correct the Record in 2016 for allegedly for workplace issues.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.